Less than a mile from Mission Boulevard in Fremont, engineers with the San Francisco Public Utilities Commission are descending deep underground to inspect the progress on a new tunnel.
We will have to tie in this piece right here in the shaft first, weld this in place, backfill concreted.
This 9-foot diameter tunnel is now open, carrying on average 62,000 gallons of water a minute each day to four Bay Area counties. It's a key step in upgrading and replacing parts of a system that has served the Bay Area for 80 years.
We're here at the new Irvington Tunnel. This is one of the most critical pieces of our system because when we're done and we put this tunnel into service, it's going to carry water that served 2.6 million people in the Bay Area.
Dan Wade is the director of the Hetch Hetchy Water System Improvement Program. At a cost of nearly $5 billion, it's one of the largest engineering projects in the nation.
The new Irvington Tunnel is steel-lined, and it has a concrete reinforcement, and that ensures that we have a reliable, earthquake-resistant tunnel well into the future.
The San Francisco Public Utilities Commission is in charge of making sure the taps keep flowing with this water. It originates 167 miles away at Hetch Hetchy Reservoir in Yosemite. But much of the system was built in the 1920s and 30s. Today, a major earthquake could leave parts of the Bay Area without water for a month.
One of the primary goals of the Water System Improvement Program is to ensure that within 24 hours after a major earthquake, we will be able to deliver water to the customers.
And to pay for it, water rates have been going up, way up, for the system's customers who live in San Francisco, San Mateo, Alameda, and Santa Clara counties.
One-third of the customers live in San Francisco, and so they're going to pay one-third of the bill, and the other two-thirds will be paid by our customers outside of San Francisco. San Francisco residents will see their water rates approximately triple by the time the program is done.
The voter-approved program began in 2004 and is scheduled to end in 2018, but there's urgency to get it done.
We have the Calaveras Fault, the Hayward Fault in the East Bay, and then, of course, the San Andreas Fault on the peninsula. And our water system crosses all three of those major faults. The U.S. Geological Survey a few years ago predicted that by 2035, there's more than a 63% chance that there'd be a major earthquake here in the Bay Area. So we're truly in a race against time.
Caesar, you got a copy, Caesar?
The work is on track, and occasionally, even ahead of schedule.
One of our most impressive projects is the new Bay Tunnel, a 5-mile pipeline underneath the San Francisco Bay, and it's the first true tunnel that's been constructed underneath the bay.
To help shield it from the shaking during an earthquake, the team built this new tunnel in a bed of thick clay 100 feet beneath San Francisco Bay. It replaces two pipelines built in 1925 and 1936 and carries water from the East Bay to San Francisco and the peninsula.
The Hetch Hetchy water system has been serving us very well throughout the 20th century and into the 21st. However, the infrastructure is old, it's aging, it's in need of repair or replacement or upgrades.
With most of the roughly 80 upgrades and replacements done, the construction crews are hard at work on the toughest and biggest project of them all.
Calaveras Dam was built in 1925. It forms Calaveras Reservoir, which is the largest local reservoir that's part of our system. We needed to permanently restrict the reservoir level to about 40% of capacity.
This new dam is being built near the Alameda-Santa Clara County line, out of earth and rock like the old dam. The new dam, however, will be seismically stronger, which will allow the Calaveras Reservoir to fill to capacity, 31 billion gallons.
California is in a severe drought. We need this reservoir for drought carryover storage. The program has a goal of meeting a drought period of 7.5 years to ensure that we can continue to supply water to our customers in that length of drought.
As bulldozers excavate dirt and rock to carve out the 220-foot tall dam, long buried treasures from the Bay Area's prehistoric past are coming to light.
Every day I come out here, I'm very excited. I get to look for fossils from creatures that lived 20 million years ago. Today we found two vertebra from a whale, probably between the size of a large dolphin and a killer whale. In the past we found shark's teeth. This is the tooth of a megalodon. It's a prehistoric shark that lived about 20 million years ago. This individual, based on the tooth size, would have been about 25 to 30 feet long. To date, we have over 650 fossils.
Nearby, the crew scour the valley's walls to make room for the new watertight foundation. But a reminder will still stand of what was once the world's largest earth and rock dam.
When this new dam is complete in 2018, we will actually cut a notch and remove about one-third of the existing dam so that the reservoir can come up against the face of the new dam.
Dan Wade and his team are more than halfway done replacing the dam, a critical step in protecting Hetch Hetchy's water from a big quake that could strike at any moment.
Water is a precious resource. We cannot live without it. We're doing something that's going to have a lasting effect to ensure the long-term health and safety and economic viability of the San Francisco Bay Area.